Rev up your engine! Today I'm going to talk about Dodge, Grand Caravan, whatever you want to call it. How the heck did they sell so many of them when they were so poorly made? Now, they've been making these things since 1984, and they now say that they're going to stop making them in 2020. What amazes me is that they made them and sold them for that long, considering the poor quality that was in them. They have a history of some of the worst automatic transmissions known to man. I had one customer. He went through 4 automatic transmissions. Now, he had it for 12 years, but still. 3 of them crapped out, and then when he was on his 4th one, he eventually just sold it. So I don't know what happened after that. I had one customer who was buying his 4th one, and I said, you had so many troubles with the previous 3. Why on earth are you buying another one? He said, oh, the wife likes to take the kids to the soccer matches, and this time I'm buying this used one, but I'm getting this long warranty on it that I'm paying for. Well, when I checked it out for him used, I said, I can hear the air conditioning compressor groaning, that's gonna go out. And about 4 months later, it blew and stopped blowing cold, but the warranty did pay for that. He showed me the warranty. I said, well, it'll cover it, so if you wanna buy it. And I've seen them with electrical problems where they don't run right, and nobody can figure out what's wrong in the computer system or the wiring system. So how did they do it? Well, a large marketing budget and a lot of space. We go inside. Comfy enough seats, utilitarian. Tons of room in a back seat. And in this case, even more seating. It's got third row seats. There's a reasonable amount of room to store stuff. And for a van, they got a cushy ride. This V6 engine puts out 180 horsepower. It's a 3.3 liter. No race car, but it's got plenty enough oomph to make it go. And on the highway, it gets decent gas mileage. This one gets 24 miles a gallon, so it can go 480 miles on the highway between Phillips. When they are running, they're good cruising vans. They were one of the first non-ugly vans. They had some style to them. Chrysler has always been that way. They make stylish looking cars. You really don't know what's inside. They broke down with grim regularity as they age. Now, this particular one was driven by an elderly gentleman most of the time. It's got over 100,000 miles on it, and it's 14 years old. It's still in decent shape. But even this older thing has the horrendous driver controlled heat, passenger controlled heat and AC. These Chrysler systems have histories of serious problems and very expensive repairs as they age. And this particular one has a really bizarro problem. If you have the air conditioner on recirculation, the temperature gauge goes to hot, but then when you take it off recirc and put it to normal, it stops overheating on the gauge. I'm assuming this is an electrical problem. I'm going to check that out later, but it's just symptomatic of how these things have wonko electrical problems as they age. But they do have cup holders all over the place. They have creature comforts. Even in the back seats here, they got plenty of headroom. They got air conditioning controls, so you can be cool in the back seat when the air conditioning is still working, and go all the way back. Even the third rows have air conditioning vents on them. So these babies sold themselves on creature comforts and on the space of what they can carry around. But I even had a customer, it's funny to laugh at now because nobody was hurt, but they were driving when they hit a bump and the airbags went off and whacked the driver in the face. And they were lucky that they were just going down an old firm country road and there wasn't anybody else around in the middle of the day. So he didn't panic too much and he just slowed down and pulled over to the side of the road. And luckily for him, there was a bar just down the street. So he went in and had a stiff drink or two and then let his friend drive it home. If you don't pay much for it, hey, I got customers who bought these things for $800, $1,000. And had them for a few years without putting too much money until either the transmission or the engine started going out. Then they either junked them or they drove them until they wouldn't run at all. Then they junked them. So you want the truth about these Grand Caravans? Hey, they sold them for a long time. A lot of people liked the creature comforts and just didn't understand about the mechanical unreliability of them as they age. So in that respect, they fit in perfectly with our society. The throwaway society. So what if it breaks when it's 4 or 5 years old? Go get another one. Well, that's not my philosophy with vehicles, but it served Chrysler pretty well with these. They sold a lot of these vans. And they also made a lot of money fixing the transmissions in them. I got a friend who's a Chrysler automatic transmission specialist at a dealership. He's made tons of money fixing the transmissions in these things. He absolutely loves them. So if you never want to miss another one of my new car repair videos, remember to ring that bell.